Hi everyone, I'm Merete Nielsen, the president for the TCI Network. Thanks a lot for this short video intermezzo during the Basque Cluster Days. It's a pleasure to be here from the distance. I want to share with you some of the latest cluster trends for clusters. Basically it's going to be a sneak peek, and I've tried to find you on the map here behind me as well. So I'm not there, you know, in person, but it's great to be here like this. And some of you know perhaps TCI Network quite well. It's a network where experts in clusters and innovation, ecosystem where we interact and learn and get inspired. So we reach out to 110 countries around the world and engage with 9,000 practitioners. We have 78 organizations that are members, and some of the oldest and strongest ones are also from the Basque countries, Orchestra and Spree, especially I want to mention here. But we're also looking for cluster organizations to become members. So if you're interested in joining the club, don't hesitate and join the others. Yeah, and of course, you know, Basque country, I'm honored to speak to you because you really go back in history, also defining a lot of the TCI history and also a lot of the on the cluster history. And starting from your perspective and your country, some of the first work on clustering was done by Michael Porter. And now it's not just in the Basque country, it's really around the world. So it's a great pleasure to travel the world now and see how the clustering has developed and also how you're still a point of reference, but also how much we can engage around the world when we talk about clusters. So it's in America, in Australia, in Latin America, we talk about clusters all over now. And this is of course because the clusters is a powerful tool. We learned that a lot when we met in the last TCI conference in Antwerp. Clusters are a great tool to transform our societies. We've done a lot of analysis over the years, showing that companies in clusters become more innovative, they become more productive, and they actually also become more international. Many SMEs struggle with that, but clusters, joining cluster organization, cluster initiatives help companies to raise the level of internationalization. So strong cluster delivers, that's really a good message for me. And some of the new things is that that clusters also help with different kind of tech transformations. One very specific case, also one that we talked about within TCI, but is on robotics. This is the Odense Robotics, situated in the middle of Denmark. I worked a lot with them. They're now considered one of the world's leading clusters in robotics. They aim is a lot of adding new technology skills to the workforce, because that's really needed if we want to push this, but also to support a very entrepreneurial tech system around Odense. So they work with incubators, have a different robotics program in the university, and also made this robotic hero program because they want to highlight that robotics are important, they are a strength in our society, and entrepreneurs helping with that transition as well is doing a great job. And another trend is that the clusters are organizing stronger and stronger ecosystems. So this is the ecosystem around the Odense Robotics. On the top level, you see all the companies engaged, and then we have a very good range of knowledge institutions, funding agencies, financiers, investors. So really trying to organize the whole system around it. And beside that, and that's also one of the core learnings, is how important the policy framework around it is. So, besides that, Odense Robotics is doing a great job. Then they have a lot of support on different levels on setting up the cluster and developing the cluster to the next phase. So actually, it's not Odense Robotics that anymore. It's a robotic alliance. They merge with another cluster and also a drone cluster. So basically, taking also the cluster to the next level. So we see more and more of those clusters building up competences, also moving across borders. There's another also tech-driven cluster within the green transition. So it's based in Copenhagen, this super cluster, the International Clean Tech Network, but a lot about green transition in the that we're facing in the middle of, and how do we work with new water technologies, energy solution, wind, many different technologies, both to improve the technologies and also to move the innovation agenda forward, and also to attract different skills from around the globe to each of these tech hubs. Yeah, so this was some of the latest trends that came out of the conference in Antwerp, and some of the things you're also talking about today, how clusters help to improve our societies, help to push tech agendas, both at the local and regional and also on the global level. So I also want to finalize by encouraging you to come to the next TCI conference in Kazan. And we will focus there more on cities and on collaboration. We also see that quite a lot in the network, how much cities are taking on this cluster concept and using it to strengthen their collaboration. So it was a pleasure to be here. Enjoy your Basque Cluster Day and hope to connect with you personally very soon.